For the past three financial years, the Kampala Capital City Authority budget has been facing a sharp decline. This financial year, the authority received 337.3 billion shillings compared to the 563 billion shillings received in the 2016-2017 financial year. Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago was again shocked to learn of a further decline in the budget from the expected 957 billion shillings next financial year to only 371 billion Uganda shillings.
Personally, I feel frustrated that they are scaling down our MTFCs, that they are slashing the budget, and without assigning any reason, there is no explanation given as to why they are doing this. And I want to again invite my colleagues not to be tempted to take another disastrous option, that is descending on the poor people to collect more local revenue. No, we are not going to take that route.
Though he promised to work within this limited budget, Lukwago cited sabotage and frustration by government, observing that the allocated funds are insufficient to fully deliver services to Kampala residents. The mayor says this will affect service delivery.
For streetlights, 13.5 billion was the original budget, but what is available is 2.7 billion. And many other sectors have been affected. KIDIP, originally we had proposed 309 billion, but we are told we can only get 63.22 billion, constituting 20% of the budget. So basically, you can see the authority is being underfunded, yet we are being told that we are under central government.
The focus is going to be shifted towards the construction of more markets to accommodate the street vendors, plus the construction and renovation of drainage channels to address the problem of floods in the city.
Property tax, which is being collected from people, is meant to do three things. The first one is work on the roads. Secondly, street lighting, garbage collection, and drainage. So we realize that as we're talking right now, government decided to take that money from the consolidated fund. So there's no way how I'm going to convince my people to pay that property tax, which is a lot, and it's like forcing them to pay money which is not going to help them.
The budget council meeting today, however, put a smile on the faces of the division mayors after it was resolved that starting with the next financial year, divisions were to start receiving a portion of the money allocated to the authority for the smooth operations at division level. Nakawa division will receive 10 billion Uganda shillings, Machindia division 7.5 billion, Kawempe 7.8 billion, Central division 8 billion, and Rubaga division will receive the lease funds that are 6.7 billion shillings.
We have been redundant. We have not been serving on any mandate since there was no devolution. But now that the authority, now that the council and the Lord Mayor have confirmed it in this budget, the implication of that is now we have the fully devolved functions by the authority, and now we have resources to serve on that mandate. I know the resources are not adequate and they will never be adequate, but we now have a start.
Initially, the outgoing KCCA Executive Director, Jennifer Musisi, had frozen the accounts of the divisions, almost rendering these leaders idle with all the major developmental projects at the divisions being carried out by the KCCA technical team. Whether to increase or not to increase property rates was also a center of debate in today's council meeting. This report was filed by Jaliet Namuwaya for Urban TV.